Welcome, folks, to tonight's game. This one promises to be a good one between the Jacksonville State Gamecocks and the Michigan Wolverines. Number 34 is one of the players that you're going to want to pay close attention to tonight.
He makes coaching easy, Brad. He plays extremely tough defense and can fill it up on offense.
The Wolverines will certainly want to take advantage of his presence on the floor. The Wolverines are not facing one of their tougher opponents, so what's the key in them not giving it away?
Well, for me, the keys are these. First, control the tempo of the game. I look for the point guard to be the floor general out there. Second of all, don't let turnovers decide the game. Protect the ball. Take care of the basketball. And lastly, be aggressive defensively. Don't give them any open looks.
Well, Dick, let's get this one started and see what happens. He dials long distance.
Let's see the replay on that one.
Controlling the ball. Trying to feed inside. He looks at the hoop. He gets that ball in the low block and immediately goes with a shot. Can't get the shot to drop.
I'll tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on the box.
And now with a power move on the inside.
Did a great job protecting the basketball, seals the defense off, and explodes to the basket.
Patience by the dribbler being shown as the offense is reset. He was doing a great job pressuring the ball and decided to go for the steal. A questionable decision, though, on his part because it resulted in a foul.
If you get the steal, you're a hero. But you always run the risk of committing a foul when you go for that steal.
Nice to have you along with us tonight. Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews alongside. I'm Brad Nessler. We got a good one going. The shot won't fall. Dumps it in. Number 22 fakes the shot.
There's the trap.
Goes up for two. And he missed. Ten-second violation.
Can't remember the last time I heard that one, Brad.
They'll throw this one in from the side.
Trying to go inside.
Conti is a motion and has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
The shooting guard with the ball. Runs him first, Dick, and then works behind.
Yeah, he's playing from behind him because that tells me right there they don't respect him as an offensive player. And they made an error, obviously. But they don't have the great respect, so they're saying, you know what? Let him get the ball and let him try to beat us.
On the dribble, gives it up. Looking for a good shot. He fakes the shot.
Set that screen away.
There appears to be a mismatch in the post.
It's definitely a mismatch.
Dick, I think there's a mismatch in the post.
Let's see if they can get him the ball.
And up, and he scores despite the hack. Trying to feed the low block.
A lot of good things happen when you bring the ball down to the inside.
Power forward takes the pass. He attempts a jump hook.
I tell you, waste any time. He got the ball in the right position, and then what it does, it keeps the defensive player away from blocking the shot when you make that turn.
West checking courtside with Aaron Andrews. Aaron?
Brad, before the game, the coaching staff told me they worried this situation could happen. They told me it's so important for the supporting cast to get involved and not rely on one player. Right now, the coaches are trying to get everyone on the bench on the same page, guys.
Thanks, Aaron. Gave it up. Count's getting high. He shows the sweet touch. They look attempt to get it to the inside. He got the steal. The pressure got to the ball handler.
Awesome ball pressure. It was too much for him, and he lost possession.
They work the perimeter, moving it around the perimeter. Definitely a foul. You talk about a packed house. Look at this crowd.
I tell you, coach's dream, baby. This gives you that edge.
The center gets the ball. Here's the toss back out from the post.
Coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
The shooting guard gets the pass. Up, easy one. Keeps the dribble as they regroup. There's a double team waiting there. From three-point range. I wonder if he's ever going to get any help from his teammates, Dick. He's doing it all and then some.
He's obviously carrying his team, Brad. His teammates need to follow his lead and join in on the action.
Shot clock is dead. Showing great patience as he waits for the reset of the offense. The power forward takes the feed. Tries to get the D to bite. Jump hook from the low block. And off the mark. The student body appears to be pumped up, and they are ready to explode.
The student body looks like they're having some fun out there.
With the bomb, off the mark, and the ball goes out of bounds. At the half, the Wolverines trail by one. Michigan has been giving up the ball like it's worth nothing.
Yeah, Brad, I don't know if I've ever seen a team turn it over the ball like this. They're basically telling their opponents to keep attacking it.
Nick, start of the second half, we take a look at our focus player, and he's going to have to be the man to come through.
Well, I think he's got to attack the basket a lot more. I think he's got to get opportunities to go to the free throw line, and that'll come if he becomes aggressive.
Bucket and in and out. May's rage has become such an essential part of Michigan athletics. This is when the student body is urged to wear a specific color in support of their team.
It's called a May's out game, Brad. Sometimes it's blue, other times it's red or yellow. It all depends. Regardless, I love it, Brad. Very soft defensively, no pressure on a basketball.
And with that, there's going to be some open jumpers if they don't pick up defensively. Boy, terrible execution on offense. Keeps the dribble as they set it up again. Leans in. Buried it.
Up and inside.
For two. Easy one. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 17 feet apart.
Now he faces up on the low block.
I think Greg, you got a post player that can face up on the defensive player and attack the basket.
Off the rim and no good. It looks as though the students are all wound up and ready to agitate the opposition.
You can't forget about them. The witty humor and dedication to their teams. You can't find this in any other team sport.
They'll work it around the arc. Defensively, low block. Oh, nice job fronting him for the steal.
Terrific job creating the opportunity. I think really converts an offensive transition.
Now they're working around the perimeter. He shoots from the top of the key. Way off target. Dick, a great battle down in the low post, but I think the offense is gaining ground here.
Yeah, he's getting great inside position, has the great angle. He's got him set up perfectly for a basket. They got the 45-degree angle, which is essential in entering the ball to the post.
he'll kick it back outside. 10 seconds to shoot. Let's go to the third member of our broadcast team. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Brad and Dick, there is a sense of concern on the bench right now. The coaching staff fears if the other players don't get involved soon, it may be too late. He keeps stressing to his team, I can't do this by myself, so help me out. We'll have to continue to monitor this one, guys, along the way.
Thanks, Aaron. This place will go senseless, Dick, if they can get a stop. Good defensive stance there against the spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot, and he did a great job. He anticipated that spin move.
Picks off the pass. For two, in and out. On the outside. This one is shaping up to be a barn burner, Dick.
Hey, down the stretch, there are so many factors that could become the difference maker. Turnovers, missed free throws, rebounding. I wonder what it will come down to in this game.
So timeout on the floor, and that gives us a break to go courtside. Here's Aaron.
Well, at this point in the game, it's about being on the same page. Each player should know what the objective is for the upcoming possession. Offensively, you must know who the number one option is, while defensively, the type of defense you're going to play or whether to foul. Time is of the essence, Brad.
Well, I think she's right about that, Richie.
A defensive stop will definitely get the fans out of their seats.
For the bucket. That comes off. Might have been some contact on the shot. Oh, and this packed house is showing their appreciation for their team.
Well, there's euphoria out there. They're really excited. They're going bananas. He missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on a box.
He drains the shot.
Let's check out this replay, Brad.
Looking for a good shot. Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man.
McCarty handles the feed. On the dribble, gives it up. The fake.
There's the screen up on top.
And a momentary look from three-point land. The power forward. Here's a block from behind.
My man was on a mission. Double team now, bad angle.
Tries for two. Up. Easy one.
Timeout charge. Hey, can we get a drum roll, Mr. Nestler? This one's going down for the last ticks, baby.
Let's get back to the action. Shot clock is dead. He goes for the trifecta.
Foul them early and give your team a chance.
Well, Dick, the shots seem to be dropping for him right now.
Well, I'll tell you one thing. They're dropping, and you better have good productivity out of your front court. When you have that balance inside-outside, you got a great chance to win. And you have to have post players that are going to make big plays.
Sometimes a stat that gets lost, Dick, turnovers, and that can kill you in a ball game.
I'll tell you, turnovers can absolutely destroy a team's performance. If you give teams easy baskets, you got no shot to win.
And the clock stopped with a foul.
Brad, I think they'll continue to do so in an attempt to get back in the ball game. They should look to foul the opponent's weakest free throw shooter.
And they continue to foul to stop the clock. Stops the clock again. And the clock stopped with a foul. And he's going to pick up the foul, and oh, look at the look on his face.
I'll tell you what, he's disgusted, but so is his coach.
bonus situation. Hits that one. Hits his second.
It's a TL, baby. Hey, it's nail-biting time. Where's my PTP? Who's going to step up and make the big shot?
You think they switch things around here for the moment, Dick?
I don't think so, but we'll wait and see, Brad.
He tries to beat the clock. He misses from long distance. Michigan kept it close for the whole game, but could not come away with a win.
This is going to be hard to swallow since they were the favorites coming into this game.
That's going to do it for us, folks. Thanks for being along. For Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nessler.